what's up? This is Tajay of the Mighty Souls of Mischief crew. So what have you got installed
for the kids today? Some dance moves?
Yeah, I figured.
A couple dance moves. I was going to teach them the robot, some other things, you know, just see how they're
doing. Yeah. Big in this place. Nothing to do with words, really.
Okay, I'm going to start with a poem. Me and Nazmus are going to do something we haven't done before. Not even in our hotel room. I'm not going to tell you what we're doing in our hotel room. And this is about why I do what I do. I stand here because oral tradition is dying. And because we don't tell stories around fires anymore. I stand here because I want you to see the ventricles hanging from my symbolism, like Daily Mail readers clinging to life by the threads of their cynicism. I want to give you links with the mallet made of tongues. They say a picture tells a thousand stories. And one day, I want to give a thousand brush strokes to one.
Lilia, what do you have to tell me about this festival?
Well, first of all, I'd like to say thank you for inviting me here. I know I've come from so far, and it's hard work. And I'm gonna perform on all stages today, tomorrow, and then So
every,
pretty popular.
Every 2 hours, I guess.
I'm called Dixolina. I'm really grateful for being here.
Rat race doesn't involve me. You're competing with the hungry, the poor, and the tenets of humanity. Millions won't bring you happiness, just unhappiness to millions. And until you realize that genocide's not just good television, then your heart is just an organ beating. The point of your existence, distance between yourself and the rest of us, shows how out of touch you are. I watch sunsets for free, my friend, and don't pay for conversation. Satan speaks to me too. I just don't listen to what he's saying.
The truth is, I'm just a groupie. And I'm pretty fucked up. I'm an alcoholic.
The devil, but more so the god. Pick one and give it a name. He liked the great pretender. Sends shivers down his crooked spine when he thinks back to the time before the time before time when they were close, shared dreams like yin and yang, tagged over with a smile, a delicate balance of belief, snapped with the kind of divine carelessness that turns people into salt and runs blood through drain pipes. The wishbone splintered halfway between the flames of hell and its smoke that billows in the sky, the place where angels reside.
Big old shark comes plowing through the window.
Yeah,
takes Dixon's head off.
It's amazing. You sit next to a porthole and you're half submerged in water. It's pretty dope. Someone sleeps here as well. Apparently.
We've got some pillows.
Yeah, nice place.
Duvet.
Rocking, rocking up.
Yeah, it must be a bit sexy.
Yeah, but look, we've got some wine, some flowers, some candles.
Yeah.
It's getting pretty romantic. Down.
For sure.
I might just bring a trapdoor.
Check that, falling asleep underneath the sky. That sounded dumb. should have put an adjective in there.
Went on drunken escapades, escaping days when his dreams had been a bit more stellar than Artois, Tarchar, Love's Dive, where life was once breathing and love was just a fuck. A fading memory of youth, a fickle fairy tale that females and faggots found appeal. At 18, it seemed that freedom was just an evening with a drink, a day without his demons, and at 21 years older looking than he should have been, he began to think that maybe I could have been more than this, more than just a dead man walking. So, talking to himself in the corner, clutching his half-empty pint glass, he asked, in this place, cluttered up with old men and